Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show on Legends 100.3, the place to fine-tune your swing, dress for the course, club, or cruise, and get tips on the best places to play and stay at the right price. Vacation or staycation, host Dan Shoub, along with his expert guests, will tell you where to go to play golf and vacation, that is. Now, here's Dan.
Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show. I'm your host, Dan Shoub. And this morning, like we typically do, we're going to talk a little golf. We're going to talk a little travel. And of course, joining me in the studio this morning is Legends Radio's own Mike McGann. Good to see you this morning, sir.
Good morning, Dan. I hope that, our favorite world traveler, international world traveler who does the entire world in a single night, brought you everything you wanted for Christmas.
Yes, lovely Christmas. I hope yours was equally lovely.
It was great, thank you.
Yes, and of course now we've got one more holiday coming up this year.
Yeah, we do, and then, I mean, things kick off and we'll kind of see what the next one brings in terms of excitement and insanity that we've had.
Yeah, you know, I typically always have very similar resolutions for the new year. And depending if I'm talking about golf or I'm talking about travel, the resolution always is to do more.
Yeah, know? I get it. And then
and then every year it's like, just like every resolution. It's like, I didn't quite get there yet.
But this happens, that happens, I get it.
Yeah, but this year I'm going to try really hard. I have a feeling that this year I'm going to have a lot more available free time to do things.
I have a sense that that just might be the case, Dan.
Yes, and I'm going to certainly focus on playing more golf. I already have plans this coming week to play with my son. He's gotten into the game, and he keeps inviting me to play, so that's always a nice thing.
Oh, that's lovely.
It is. And also when it comes to travel, I'm going to try and do more as well, try and review more places for all the listeners too. Obviously, whenever I travel anywhere, it's fair game. So I will always share my the good, the bad, and the ugly with everybody. So if you're a traveler who's listening, you'll want to stay tuned in the coming year. And if you are a hotel, restaurant, entertainment venue, and you need to be reviewed so our listeners can hear, well, reach out to me and we can set that up as well. The best way to find me is to go to facebook.com/thegolfandtravelshow, like the page, send comments to me, and we can arrange for reviewing your location so that everybody knows about it.
It's a great idea. I can pass a few your way as well because I do a lot of local stays.
Yeah, well, and I always say that even though we are the travel show, there's always the folks that live here that need just a quick little weekend or one night getaway.
Oh, yeah.
And of course, all the other folks that listen through our app or are streaming on our website. Or if you live here and you have people that come down here to visit you down here, you need to know where to go and what to do with them.
Especially this time of year. So
yes.
Yeah, that's a great point.
Yes.
So stay tuned. We're going to have some of that coming up in the new year.
We will. And in the golf world, which is kind of winding down until next year, but last week we did have a big event. It was not an official event. It's what we used to call a silly season event, or these days perhaps an unsanctioned event.
Unsanctioned, yes.
And it used to be known as the Father-Son, and now it is simply known as the PNC Championship, because it's not only fathers and sons, it's sons and fathers and grandfathers and daughters and granddaughters and folks that play on the Champions Tour, as well as the PGA Tour, and as well as the LPGA Tour, all join in now.
Right.
And even though it is unofficial, any of the players who play in it will tell you that is the event that they look forward to more than any event during the course of the year.
It makes sense. I get that.
Yeah, there's a tiny bit less pressure, although still some pressure, and an opportunity to just make incredible memories with their children, parents, grandparents, etc.
It's so, sharing the love of the game that's gotten them where they are.
It and is. And for the fans, it's great, too, because it's not quite as crowded. You get a little bit more up close and personal. You get to hear the players get more signatures, autographs, if you're into that. And on TV, they're mic'd, so you get to hear the banter that you typically might not hear during an official event.
Right.
And, of course, there was a lot of interest this year. It was sold out in advance with the anticipation, which actually came true, that Tiger Woods would make his first appearance since his injuries, along with his son Charlie.
Right.
And sure enough, at the last minute, he did decide to show up. And not only did he show up, but he made his presence known like the old days, where he charged at the end with 11 straight birdies with his son Charlie and almost won the event.
Good heavens.
Came in second. It was close. Obvious, he's not 100%. He still can't quite bend down all the way. He grimaces when he hits full swing shots, you know, like tee shots. So you could tell that he is not quite ready. He did have to use a golf cart, which he got permission for. But after the event, when asked if he would petition for a regular PGA Tour event for a cart, he said no, that that's not his style. If he can't compete equally with everybody else and until the time that he's ready, he will not. So, but people are excited because he sure showed some really good form, especially on the shorter shots. Accuracy, finesse, it was there.
Look, I mean, Tiger at 60%. Is going to dominate most fields.
Exactly.
I mean, it's just the way it is.
But scarier than that, his 12-year-old son, Charlie, is already starting to exhibit a lot of the same success and traits as his father.
Well, genetics, passion, training like that, you bring it together, and,
yep.
and that's a recipe for success.
Yes. Unfortunately, slightly lost in the shuffle a little bit was the winning team, the Dailies. John and John II.
Nice.
Who, you know, they have their ups and downs, but they're still talented. Just had a great event and won. You know, Little John isn't so little anymore.
Right.
Used to be called Little John. Now he's John Daly II.
Yes.
Not even junior. He
no,
doesn't want to be
seconds.
Junior.
Yeah.
He's a big boy. And Dad, at the dinner earlier in the week, dressed up as Santa. Very appropriate,
that
as
fits.
He's got like a long white beard now and
yes,
long white hair and doesn't even need a pillow.
He's still John Daly, isn't he?
And earlier in the week as well, his video kind of made the rounds because after having a few drinks, which for him is like 20 or 30, shows up at Taco Bell on film, places a small order for $500 worth of Taco Bell.
I've kind of been there. I get it.
Yeah, it's very John Daly-esque.
It is. But I'll tell you, the thing about Daly is, regardless of all that, as far as like natural talent, like you look at the guy, he doesn't look like a pro golfer and really never has.
Never
ever.
Did. Never did.
But his talent, his coordination, the guy is just, he's next level.
If he wasn't 100 pounds overweight and half drunk most of the time, imagine how good he would have been.
Right? I mean, the guy is just, his talent level is absurd.
And speaking of talent level, the Stensons played as well. And the little one, Carl, was asked what his chances look like in the event. And this was his first event, and I think he's like 11 years old. And he took a look at his dad, Henrik, and said, the way he's been playing, I don't think so.
That's awesome. I love that. But again, that's the great part about that event, Dan.
It's crazy. And one last golf story, because I know you like these kinds of stories. There's a fellow by the name of Neil, and I found this in The Sun, which you have to hope it's true, because, okay, you know, yeah, although these gossipy kind of publications these days are more true than the regular news ones.
Usually, they're actually more balanced.
But,
yes,
but this guy, he's been playing since the age of five, and he never had a hole-in-one until this past June.
Okay,
he plays about twice a week, has a low handicap, like 2.5 is his handicap. So he's obviously a good golfer.
Yeah,
but since June, he went out there and made 11 hole-in-ones in 6 months' time.
I think there's something wrong with your mic. Yeah. I thought you... it sounded like you said 11
hole-in-ones. 11 hole-in-ones
no.
in a six-month period. They say that the odds of doing that are several billion to one.
And I can't win most scratch-off lotto.
He doesn't understand it either, and it's gotten to the point where every day when he goes to play golf, he comes home and people says, hey, did you get a hole-in-one today? And oftentimes the answer is yes at this point.
That's insane.
So crazy stuff happens. Golf is just a funny game.
All
right, I think what we're going to do is take a quick break, and we've got some news for you on travel. We've got some incredible deals on travel. You won't want to miss it, so stay tuned. We'll be back with more of the Golf and Travel Show.
Well, I've been working on my short game.
Are you tired of searching for the job you need with the flexibility you want? Whether you're looking for a temporary or permanent position, you need to call Labor Finders. We're already in your community putting people back to work every day. Select from hundreds of daily job listings with companies who are hiring all over the country. With nearly 200 offices nationwide, Labor Finders has temporary and temporary to hire employment opportunities for skilled, semi-skilled, and general labor positions, such as electricians, landscapers, flaggers, hospitality, and more. Connect with a personal job agent today to navigate your next career step by calling your local Labor Finders office or by visiting laborfinders.com.
Four. Straight down the middle. It went straight down the middle. Then it started to hook just a wee bit. And that's when my caddy lost sight of it. That little white pellet has never been found to this day. But it went straight down the middle, like they say.
And we are back. And I think I had mentioned last week, I hadn't heard from them, but I had mentioned them anyway. And this week I did hear from them. So I want to remind everybody that during the holidays, we all like to have a cocktail or two, and we don't want to drive. And AAA, they do offer a what they call tow to go. If you've had too much to drink and you're the driver, you don't have a designated driver, they will come and pick you up and get you home safely, free of charge. And this runs through after the new year till Monday morning, January 3rd.
And I can tell you that there are, just from my standpoint, a little value added here. There are also AA meetings that happen pretty much every hour during this time of year.
It's a tough time of year. And yeah, for many people, it's a wonderful time of year. For other people, it's a difficult time of year. And right. We can't afford to lose any listeners.
You're exactly right. And neither can their families. Good point. So if you
please.
Need it, have AAA drop you off at AA.
Exactly. So the phone number you could call is 855-2-TOW-2-GO. That's the numeral 2 each time. 2-TOW-2-GO or 855-286-9246. Give them a call. Write it down. Put it in your phone, because after you're drunk, it might not be so easy to remember.
Yeah, 286-9246, I think you said.
Yes, 855-286-9246.
Yeah, that's a good number.
855-2-TOW-2-GO.
It's a great service.
Yes. And travel and travel deals are still out there, for better or worse, because COVID is still out there.
Omicron.
Yes, it's certainly heating up a little bit. Places like Israel have banned travel to the U.S., so they can't come here. Other places have had all sorts of restrictions as well. New York City, the mayor has closed New Year's Eve celebration down to like 25%, I think, capacity or something. He didn't get rid of it altogether, I guess, because of the TV coverage and stuff. They didn't want to interrupt that. But you do have to be vaccinated and prove it, I believe, to get in. Broadway shows, most of them are closed now.
Yes.
The Christmas show with the Rockettes at Radio City closed.
Kicked to the curb.
Yeah. Just a lot of things are, closing down right now. Although travel from South Africa is going to reopen, I guess. We had shut that down. But it seems that this new Omicron strain, it comes in really bad and really fast and goes. So
South Africa, it's already, I mean, I was reading an article that said they expect, even in New York and the areas like that, that Omicron will probably peak this week.
Yes.
And then go down from there. So
for better or worse, it's going to be bad, but it's going to be quick. They also say that potentially the severity might not be as bad, although the contagious nature is bad.
Right. It's more contagious, but apparently
less severe.
Less dangerous overall. So
right. But you still don't want to be sick. You still don't want to be passing it to other people.
I agree. We still have vulnerable populace. So yeah.
Correct. But the good news is that because of the uncertainty, the good deals are still around. So we'll talk about those in just a few minutes. So it has its pluses and minuses. And of course, for those of you who are more adventurous, especially those who feel it's safer to travel because you have been vaccinated, the deals are there, and there's always the opportunity to cancel and postpone. Sometimes you get your money back. Sometimes you could just, postpone to another date when you're not sick or you feel more comfortable. So it can be a bit of a hassle, but if you're flexible and willing to put up with the chance of a bit of a hassle, incredible deals are out there. For instance, believe it or not, there are still new businesses that are starting up amongst all of this mess. Back in the day, there were several discount carriers based in Iceland, and a few of them didn't make it. Well, a new one is back, and back here, you know, for this, from the States as well. It's called Play Airlines, and they do go to Europe via Reykjavik, and they are starting out with two different East Coast U.S. Locations, although, unfortunately, Florida is not one of them. Baltimore and Boston is where they're going to be starting. I'm sure that other cities will follow thereafter. And from Baltimore and Boston, they'll be going to London, Berlin, Brussels, Copenhagen, Dublin, Paris, and Gothenburg, Sweden, Stuttgart, Germany, and some other Norwegian cities as well. It's going to be ultra low cost, and the tickets are starting out really, really cheap. I don't see exactly how much, but I believe under $100 for starters. But of course, this is an ultra discount type carrier, so you know everything is going to be extra. Keep that in mind. There was a brawl this past Monday night at Miami International Airport. Two people were taken into custody, so the bad behavior has not stopped. People are still fighting. Here's a picture you could take a look at and see.
Good Lord.
I know.
Look, I mean, honestly, it's like people are, it's like pro wrestling. I'm watching a battle royal there.
Yes, it's pretty crazy. So, you know, some guy, I guess, was beaten up on one of the officers as well. The officer pulled out a weapon and other people had to de-escalate it. It could have been worse. There could have been fatalities if cooler heads did not prevail. Also, I think I had seen in the news that we had spoken about that case where the flight attendant was punched in the face.
Yes, and I remember that.
Was bloodied and had teeth broken and stuff. And I believe that that culprit was taken into court and found guilty, I believe, and is going to be sentenced for that as well.
Good.
And yes,
that's just good news.
The sentences have been pretty strict, you know, and obviously a lot of these things that are happening, again, alcohol related.
Of course.
You know, I would tell everybody to just, you know, stay calm. But of course, when they're totally drunk, that's when, you know, stupid things seem to happen. So
I have very little patience for that.
I do, too. And you know, I'm not against drinking, and I think people should do what they want and have a good time. But when it gets to the point where other people get involved in a really bad way, that's when it needs to stop.
Getting behind the wheel, I get all of it. And I have very little patience for lawbreakers in general, Dan.
Yeah, it just, I mean, freedom is great when it's to yourself. But again, once it starts to affect other people's freedom, not so great anymore.
I get you.
So anyway, as I mentioned, due to the crazy world we live in, that's why there are such great deals that are out there. Again, we just have to change our levels of expectation. We have to leave extra time because weird things happen. We have to be flexible. We have to be calm. And amongst all of that, you can still get some incredible deals. I mean, why not?
I agree. I mean, look, they're there. And I mean, why not? They take the negative, turn it into something of a positive with this.
Exactly. So my advice to every one of you listening is stay tuned, because in just a minute or two, we're going to have some incredible deals for you. You won't want to miss it. And we'll be back with more of the Golf and Travel Show.
If I could keep it in the fairway, I'd be a...
Do you have a project with an upcoming deadline but don't have the manpower to finish on time? Or maybe your business just took on a new client and has a sudden demand for qualified professional workers. Whatever your business needs, Labor Finders has got you covered. Gain access to a steady stream of workers who want to work with an agency that always has placements. With over 40 years of experience in the staffing industry, your staffing problem is no problem to our team of experts. Labor Finders covers many services and costs so you can save time and money while getting employees you can count on today. We take pride in setting safety standards. Work with Labor Finders today, the best of staffing winner for 10 consecutive years. From event hosts, chefs, and housekeepers to general laborers, electricians, and landscapers, we have the workers you need. Consult with one of our nearly 200 offices today to see how we can help staff your next big project at laborfinders.com.
We'll be right back.
And we are back. And this segment, I know, is one of your favorites, as well as a lot of the listeners, because we do get phone calls and messages.
It's just so cool. Like, I mean, it, you know, I'm not someone that, honestly, I don't have much time. You know me. And I have a lot of travel dreams. And these are the things that I say, wow, maybe I can actually pull this off if I can string more than 2 days off in a row.
Yeah, we got to talk to the boss here. We need some more backup so that you can
thankfully,
get away.
I'm going to give a shout out to Dawn.
Yes.
For, I mean, wow, how much help she has given me. So, Dawn, I hope you had a Merry Christmas, and I'll see you tomorrow.
And you'll send her a postcard from your next trip when I give you some of this advice here. So, all right. So, as you all know, oftentimes I find some deals for packages or for lodging on TravelZoo.com, and the next couple are found there. First up is a great city to visit, winter, spring, summer, or fall. You can drive there or you can fly there relatively cheap, either or. I am talking about Asheville, North Carolina.
Oh, yeah.
Great city, lots of arts, great dining. Of course, the weather can be really cool during any of those times. Biltmore Estate, their winery, great place to visit. Can be expensive for lodging there, but right now, this deal for lodging at the Renaissance downtown, so it's right downtown, so you can walk to all the restaurants and galleries and things like that.
Okay.
In January and February, as little as $99 to $119 per night.
Okay. For that in Asheville?
Yes. Wow. And this is a Renaissance, so of course it's part of the Marriott brand. So if you are a member of their program, you can also get some points, although you might not on the hotel because when you book it separately, not always, or if it's a special, so you never know. In March and April, it goes up a little bit, starting at $149 to $219.
Right.
Of course, that's an incredible time of year in the spring.
Yeah, it's beautiful, and that's a killer deal.
There's no resort fees. Kids are free if you stay with the same bedding, free Wi-Fi. Pet-friendly, but there is an extra fee, of course, and just a great location within two blocks of all the bars and restaurants on Broadway. Oh. So, again, you can find this on TravelZoo.com. Here is an all-inclusive to a island that is typically outrageously expensive. This is a relatively new place that's recently been renovated. On the beach, beautiful oceanfront views from your room in St. Lucia. So this is an all-inclusive package, is not including airfare, but hotel, meals, alcoholic beverages, oceanfront balcony. All of that for two people for five nights, January through April, starting at $1,749.
Okay, all inclusive.
Yeah, so it's like under $200 per person per night, and you're getting meals, alcohol, and lodging, beachfront, balcony.
Yeah, that's
and this is St. Lucia. This isn't Mexico. Mexico, sometimes you could get some cheap deals, but you might not want them.
But no,
this is top notch.
St. Lucia is.
Yes, and they do have upgrades available, a junior suite starting at just under $2,000 and additional huge suites at a little over $2,000. And like I say, this includes everything. Flights right now out of Miami to St. Lucia are not that expensive either. And again, this is typically a Caribbean island that is not cheap.
It's hard to get to it.
Yes.
So, yeah, I mean, that's a big part of this.
Yes, and not, you know, again, this is, you're not going to be staying with a million kids or anything. This is like an adult kind of a thing.
Yeah, it's a real getaway. Wow.
Yes. Here's another deal a little bit further away, place that I love, want to get back to. We're talking about Italy, again, found on TravelZoo through Exotica, a very reputable firm. This is Rome, Florence, and Venice, four-star hotels, guided tour, and airfare. All of this eight nights of lodging, starting at $1,499 per person.
Okay, wait. All right. So you got eight nights of lodging, right?
Yes.
Airfare's in there, you said.
Yep, airfare, four-star hotels.
Guided tours.
Yep. You get breakfast every morning. Entry fees to the entire itinerary, all ground transportation, airport transfers, and this includes airfare out of Fort Lauderdale or Miami starting at $1,499.
Mike, when you put that all together, that is significantly, I mean, it's less than $200 a night.
Right.
For
with
everything.
Everything,
you take
yeah.
the airfare out of that.
The only thing it doesn't include is like lunches and dinners, but let's face it, you're in Italy, so it's kind of nice to be able to go on your own.
And
pizza is not expensive, but it is gourmet compared to what we get here for
spaghetti
pizza.
Spaghetti pizzas and everything. They have a lot of crazy pizzas in Italy.
Crazy.
Very creative and tasty.
I could live on the gelato. I don't even need, I just go straight to the dessert.
Dan, I have an addictive personality. I would live and die by the gelato in 48 hours.
It's crazy. Speaking of crazy, I got one more package found on Travelzoo to a country I love, a town I haven't been to, but I know people who have. They say it's lovely. We're talking about Phuket in Thailand.
Thailand, yes.
Okay, absolutely gorgeous. A five-star resort with water views for a week, including a couple of meals and a couple of massages, starting at $629 for two.
Okay, wait.
For a week.
They're not missing a one at the beginning of that.
No, so this doesn't include airfare, but this is like $100 a night or less.
It's less than
for
that,
two.
Significantly.
Okay, and this includes a deluxe room with a furnished terrace. You get breakfast every morning. You get one 60-minute Thai massage for both of you.
Oh, Thai
massage. A two-course dinner for both of you. Free Wi-Fi, late checkout, 20% off food and drinks. Crazy. I mean, it's just crazy. So go to Travelzoo and go to Thailand Phuket. It's gorgeous.
That may be my favorite food in the world is Thai.
Oh.
And actual Thai. I mean, oh.
It is so good. And when you leave the hotel, or when you're in the hotel, it's inexpensive. You leave the hotel, it's dirt cheap and still good.
Yeah.
Airfare only deals. Go to Google Flights. Just put in the city you're going to and going from. Cincinnati from Orlando, nonstop round trip, $97. Remember, you fly into Cincinnati to get into Kentucky. So if you want to go do like the Bourbon Trail and the horses and all that stuff, $97 nonstop round trip.
What a deal.
Los Angeles, nonstop round trip from Miami or Orlando, $137 to Los Angeles, nonstop
to
round
LA?
Trip. LA. And these are not on discount carriers, these are the major carriers. Montreal from Fort Lauderdale, $177 nonstop round trip, Miami $174, or Toronto $159 from Fort Lauderdale and $191 from Orlando nonstop round trip.
All under $200.
Yes, I love Canada. Belize from
okay, yes.
Miami nonstop round trip, $221. Great place for diving.
Wow.
Not so much for golfing, but if you love the ocean and diving
well,
and
Belize
fishing,
is
gorgeous. And last but not least, one of my favorite cities in the world, Amsterdam from Miami round trip, $484.
I'm sorry, round trip to Amsterdam is under $500.
Yes, and it is a lovely place to visit.
Good
I can't
Lord.
Recommend it more. I hear our music, so just want to remind everybody, facebook.com/TheGolfAndTravelShow. Like the page, and you will be up to date on our guests. And also, you can send me messages. Happy to help you with any advice that you need on your travel or golf. And make sure that you tune in again next week, same time, same place, for another episode of The Golf and Travel Show. And in the meantime, hit them straight.
Where my thoughts escaping home, where my music's playing home, where my love lies waiting silently for me.
Thanks for listening to the Golf and Travel Show hosted by Dan Shube. Dan's here every Sunday at 7 a.m. to help you hit him straight, whether you're in Palm Beach County or traveling around the world. We'll see you next Sunday morning for more of the Golf and Travel Show right here on Legends 100.3.